in the first part of this video, we had set up our tab navigator and our header component. In this part, we'll try and set up the rest of the UI components of the Explore tab. And if there's enough time, we'll set up the animation of the header component as well. So let's begin. So we'll start by first importing the scroll view here at the top. And coming down here below our header view, let's put in the scroll view. And inside the scroll view, we'll set up a property called scroll event throttle. And we'll set that to the maximum value, which is 16, so that it sends back responses as fast as possible on each scroll. Let's put in another view inside this. And we'll put in another text, which will be the main heading. So all it says is, what can we help you find? And let's just style this text here. So we'll say style is equal to, and we'll give it a font size of 24, a font weight of 700, and a padding horizontal of 20. So that it's nicely spaced from the edges. Let's also style the parent component by giving it a flex of 1 so that it takes up all the place available here with a background color of white. And let's space it from the top by giving it a padding top of 20. Next, we're looking at our horizontal scroll view component here, which has the three categories. So inside this view, let's put in another view here. Let's add some styles to this. We'll give it a height of 130 and let's put a margin top of say 20. Now what we want is we want to be able to scroll the components that we place here horizontally. So we'll put in another scroll view here. And inside this, we'll put in our custom component, which we'll create right now. So let's just first create it and then we'll move it out into its own file. So let's put in a view here. Let's give that view a height of 130, which is the height of the parent. And let's also give it a width of 130. So that's a nice square. Inside this, let's put in another view. The top half will have the image and the bottom half will have the text. So for that, let's import image here. Before we put in the image, let's create another view so that we know that it's divided into two parts. The top part, let's give the top part a flex of 2 and the bottom part a flex of 1. We want the image to be taking up slightly more space than the text. This is what we're trying to achieve. So we want the image to take the top half and the text the bottom half. Now let's put in the image in the top half. So we'll say image source is equal to, let's require the image. So in my assets folder, I already have the image. It'll be available with the code on my GitHub profile as well. And let's close out this tag. Obviously, we need to style this image. So let's give this image some styles. So we'll say style is equal to, let's give it a flex of 1, a width of null, a height of null, and let's give it a resize mode of cover. And I just noticed I've put in two heights here. This should be width. So let's change that. And there we have our first component. Now we've got the image part set up, let's put in the text. So in the bottom part, we'll put in a text and let's just pass in home here for the first image. Let's style this text container. Let's give it a padding left of 10 and a padding top of 10. And let's also add some styles to the main container. So along with the width and the height, let's give it a margin left of 20 and a border width of 0.5 with a border color of a nice light gray. So there we've completed our component. Now let's make this reusable by moving it into its own file. So here let's create a new folder called components. And inside that we'll create another folder called explore and we'll put in the file category.js for each category. Let's import some boilerplate code in here and let's call this class category. Let's copy this view from here and move it out into the category file. And instead of passing in hard-coded data, we'll change this and pass in props. So let's say this.props.imageuri. And for the text, let's say this.props.name. Now let's import category in here into the Explore tab. So here on top, let's say import category from components slash explore slash category. And back here in the scroll view, let's pass in category. So we see we're getting an error here. So inside category, let's import image to get rid of this error. And once we've got that, we've got an empty box here. So as you remember, we'd passed in props there. So here, let's say image URI is equal to, and we'll require the image here instead. So the first one, we want to get the assets folder and we want to get home for that. We also want to pass in a name, which is home. Let's capitalize that. And there we can see we're getting a component again. So let's just duplicate this twice and let's change the images. So let's make this one experiences. And here let's make this one restaurant. Let's also change the text up here. And as you can see, we're not seeing other images come up here. So in our scroll view, let's put in a property called horizontal and set that to true. And there our images are showing up now. If we scroll right now, we'll see this scroll bar at the bottom. Let's get rid of that by saying shows horizontal scroll indicator and set that to false. And there we have our scroll view completed. Now that we've got the scroll view set up, below this view, we'll put in our Airbnb Plus view over here. So let's put in another view and let's pass in a text inside that. Let's say introducing Airbnb Plus. Let's style the parent view by giving it a margin top of 40, a padding horizontal of 20, and also let's style the text, which will be similar to the main heading at the top, by giving it a font size of 24 and a font weight of 700. We'll put in another text here, which will be the subheading, and let's just copy the heading from the app. Let's style that text now. So let's give it a font weight of 100 and a margin top of 10. And that looks much better. Below this, we want to display a big image here. So below this text, let's put in another view. And in that view, we need an image tag. Before we put in the image, let's import something known as dimensions here, so that we can get the width of the screen and accordingly put the image. So here at the top, let's just say const height and width. And let's just get that from dimensions.getWindow. And this should be dimensions. Here inside the image, let's say source is equal to and require the image from assets folder. And we'll use the home image for it. So there we're getting the image, and as always, we need to style it. So let's first style the parent component. We'll say style is equal to, let's give it a width, which is the width of the screen which we got on the top from dimensions, minus 40, so that we have 20 each side. Give it a height of 200 and let's give it a margin top of 20. Next, let's style the image. So style is equal to, let's give it a flex of 1, a height of null and a width of null, so that it takes up all the space available, and a resize mode of cover. Also, we want to give it a border radius of 5 and a border width of 1 and a border color of our gray color. So now we've got the basic UI setup. There's also one part at the bottom that I want to show here, which has homes around the world shown in different components. That's left, and we've got our tags at the top left, which are going to be animated. That I'll complete in the next video. Till then, you guys can try this out, and please like and subscribe.